Okay. Anybody else? Any other takers? Just you? Oh, and you. You can dodge attacks by... Yeah, we know this. It's too far away. Come on. Oh! Try to sneak up behind me. Oh, a couple of you guys, huh? And what if I do this? So I can't do anything until they split. Almost there. Here?
Time to make some serious changes.
Check manuscript.
The wool was in place, the oil was flowing, the battery was attached, the lights were blinking, the CD was playing, and the boombox.
Okay. Oh wait, did I do it wrong? I think I did it wrong. Wheels in place. Battery is attached. Yeah, battery is attached. The lights are blinking. It does not matter what order I would do. I think I would have messed up by now if it was.
We write really for the first time.
Okay. I guess I'm running.
It's a fire!
Sorry, lady. I'm burning down your home. I don't need that. Ooh, satellite. Let's go poke it. Oh no, that doesn't sound good.
I think I hear more of them.
Yeah, I think I noticed.
We did the big guy first.
Got
Come on! No. Stop it.
That's the last of them. We're good.
Where'd you go?
What the hell was that?
Easy. I got him. You're safe. I need you to tell me what you know about him. The guy who looks like me.
There was a party in one of the rooms. It was pretty wild. I'm not sure which room it was in.
You didn't attend?
No, I wasn't there. But it got way out of hand. Anyway, I heard that he went to the diner and there was a fight there or something. Maybe you could find out more from there. I got some keys that you can maybe
use. Of course
you
do.
You just happen to have the keys, huh? Fine. I'll take a look. Stay here.
You're working with them, aren't you?
Like hell. I'm getting out of here as soon as you leave so I could close up this place and go home.
Emma, you really want to stay here in the light.
Yeah, thanks for the advice, but I'm not sticking around. Just go already, okay?
Great voice actress. Okay. Because we can try to take more. And then, ooh, manuscripts are over here? I miss a lot of things. Oh, I could go in doors. Can I go in doors? But it's right there! Oh, go in the other room? No? Is there like a back door? I think so. Way to get in through a back window. Oh, maybe I'll get keys for this place eventually. That would probably make sense. Alright, we are off to the diner to get a overly cooked hamburger. Pretty. Inner. Don't need to heal myself. I wonder if we're
a poltergeist. Its existence is one of rage and hostility, and its very presence turns ordinary objects into deadly projectiles.
Shit!
Stop it! Oh crap. Hello? Ooh, a page. Press F5. Too many legs.
The strands of webbing glistened in the beam of my flashlight, fine, almost ethereal. They were fresh and right in my path. I held my breath and waited, ear straining. Nothing. I moved on, concentrating on the task at hand. Just get what I was looking for, then leave. That's all I keep telling myself. For a moment, I actually thought it might be as simple as that. Then, I heard too many legs skittering across the ground.
Joy! This can only bode well for us, right, guys? Maybe that's where we exit.
The scene. Traces of violence.
Up keys.
A callous midnight snack. A room key left carelessly behind. The man recognizes the enemy's handiwork.
I think these are keys for the motel rooms.
It's blood. My God. Mountain Red Tooth Observatory.
Satellite and now this? That place might be involved.
What's this? New fishing man! Am I hearing something? Oh, fan. It was like a car coming up. I was like, oh no. Okay, can't go on back. This is it? Am I done in here? What does this say? This old chair. A great renovation. Oh, more blood. Okay, now we're just moving on. Why are there so many cars? I wonder if we can use them later on.
Emma Sloan was a believer in a great many things, most of which were entirely fallacious.
Fallacious. I thought she was leaving.
Emma Sloan, an innocent victim of his dark half. More collateral damage in the ongoing war. Damned by forces beyond her control, as much as by her own actions.
I thought her actions were she was going to leave, but she didn't. We're the ones who told her to stay. Wouldn't it be our actions? Hey, it's you guys! Die. 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 Take two out. Okay, so did she turn into one of them, or? It's a very heavy, just shoot 'em up, which I knew about. It's one of the reasons why I didn't really want to play it too much. Oh, it's right there, okay. I want to check out in here.
Damn it! Why didn't you listen?
What? Wait, did I not hear him right? I thought I told her to stay in here. Stay in the light. Get some more ammo. And then we'll go in this one that has the paper in it. Room service. My fluffy pillow. Six of 53.
The twisted mirror.
My own face peered back at me from the TV screen. For a moment, I struggle with the sensation of déjà vu. How many times have I seen myself like this now? And then there was that easy grin that never seemed quite as quick or natural on my own lips. The dark, malicious twinkle in the eyes. And I knew who I was looking at. As he pulled back and revealed the room behind him, my throat went dry. There was nothing I could do but watch.
I'm in the closet. Okay, that's it for this place. And then we have this one over here.
Michael Farabee, dead, tortured, dressed in clothes that bore the name of a local observatory. A slim lead, but solid enough. It stirs something deep in his mind. He knows where to go now.
Something to do with outer space? Mr. Scratch is an alien? The darkness is an alien? My god, the revelations.
Oh no.
The observatory. Hot on the heels of the Herald of Darkness, the Champion of Light forges on to see the stars.
Okay.
An observatory. A place for a man to witness the magnificence of the universe. But such insights are not what the Champion of Light is looking for. He has come to find a weapon.
The ultimate weapon. Oh, really? I drove. All right. I wasn't really finished with what I was doing, but sure. Let's go ahead and move on. Can I just leave? Just drive and go away? Welcome, Airy Map Legendary. Legendary? Wow. It doesn't matter. Let's just explore everything. Hello? Yes, I need admittance for one. Monitored by video camera. Ooh, radio. Which we already have, so it doesn't really matter. Let's pick up the shiny new one.
Welcome back, listeners. As you know, I'm Eddie Rodman, and I'm still talking to old gods of Asgard, who are doing their big comeback tour. How's that been going for you?
Splendid! I'm having the time of my life! You know, I didn't realize how much I missed that.
And what about you, Tor?
It's okay, you know.
Well, this must bring back a lot of memories.
Oh, yeah! It's wonderful to be back on stage. If it wasn't for my knee, I'd feel like a young man again.
Well, speaking of that, I hate to keep harping on this age thing, but I gotta tell you, I've heard your new songs, guys, and you sound really good.
Thank you.
And,
guy sounds a little bit different.
Touchy subject,
that old guy.
To be blunt, you really don't sound, old. I mean, the difference between your speaking voice and your singing voice, it's pretty striking.
What the hell are you talking about? You saying it's not us singing on that record?
What? What's he talking about?
No, I'm not saying that, guys, but I can't help noticing the difference.
Son, you're on thin ice.
You calling me a liar?
Whoa, hey, let me just step in here for a moment, boys. Yeah, Eddie, they do sound different, but believe me, we're not talking Milli Vanilli here. These guys are the real deal. Why don't you come to the gig tomorrow night and see for yourself? Once they get on that stage, boom, things get real.
Really?
Believe me, they play like they're possessed. It's almost like magic. Look, you see my boys play, you see the old gods for real. These guys project a lot of power. They're not lightweights, you know what I'm saying?
All right, Barry, I'll see if I can make it. Now, let's take another quick break here, and after that, we'll play the new Old Gods of Asgard single. Don't you go away.
Possessed. I see what you did there, game. Can I help you? Something I can do for you? North Observatory. We go that way. We go this way. That way has light. This way doesn't. I'm gonna go this way. Stanley Home Improvements. Wait for me to get up there? Probably not. Well, sort of. Jump for it! Of course, you know I could, like, stack a box or two and get up there, but. Who needs logic? Found a tire. die, Stan Lee. Where'd he go? Did I kill him? Alright. I don't need to go that way, so we'll just go up. Let's switch to our Uzi for a while. Submachine gun. Maybe I should put this on the nightmare mode. So far, it's not too bad. The question mark. Pressure.
The pressure of success got to me. My wife Alice was the sole thing in my life that anchored me. Suddenly it wasn't enough. I couldn't write anymore. I distracted myself with wild parties and whatever trouble I could scare up. I wallowed in the drama of my life, sure that Alice would stick with me even though she didn't sign up to be the lifeline of a tortured artist. It was my dumb luck she's not the type to give up.
Yay, Alice. Another question mark. We're going to go for that. This way we can learn more about what's going to happen to us. I really can't wait for the next Element game. Of course, we're having to wait on... What is it, the game they're working on right now? Quantum Break? It looks really good. I hope it's going to be a fantastic game. But I'm hoping... that after they're done with that, they'll start on Alan Wake 2.
The spiders aren't really the work of the enemy. They're a side effect. A part of the Dark Place's less significant fauna that has managed to slip through the opening I made when I arrived. Less an animal than an idea that has assumed the form of an animal. Makes them no less dangerous. But at least they're a little easier to deal with. The darkness doesn't protect them like the Taken, and thus they can be destroyed by either light or bullets right away.
Neat! Okay, but I'd rather keep my shot. Well, it would be good for long, further range, though. Yeah, we'll switch it up for a while. What's that over there? Okay, nothing. Let's just go ahead and go in. No! Hello!
I'm Dr. Rachel Meadows, and... Wait a moment, it's you! I can't believe you dare show your face around here again.
And you're probably going to die too, just like the... wrench lady. No! Give me a second. Crotch shot! It's being a little too crotchety.
Go away.
It wasn't me. I just look like him.
Are you serious? That's what you're going with? Please!
I'm trying to stop him. You saw those shadow things trying to kill me, right? I bet he got along with them just fine.
Yes. Yes, he did. Alright, come on in.
Thank you.
Really? You know, I can't even think, well, maybe you're just fooling me. No, it's just, sure, why not? And that's why you're gonna die, lady. Oh, finally, man. I need to go to the bathroom for, like, the past hour. Mount Red Tooth, National Observatory.
Hey, buddy.
Ah.
I figured I'd take a moment to talk to you. There's a party next door. I'm feeling pretty good right now. A little beer, a little fun, you know? It's nice. This whole thing between us, it's a little weird for me too, you know? I mean, we don't just look the same, there's a lot we share. I mean, up here, I know you, right? So I was thinking maybe we could... These guys are getting out of control. Look, I feel like we're both victims of circumstance here. And maybe we could make some kind of effort to...
Take your time.
Never mind.
What? Okay. Ooh. There she is.
Just a moment, I'll send the lift down to you.
Can I just...
I didn't expect to see anyone here tonight, but I'm relieved to see an actual person. That's assuming this isn't some kind of cruel trick on your part, of course.
What? Me? No. I'm not the guy who just went and beat up a bunch of people that were at a party that apparently I made. So now my mouse moves a little bit. No, whenever it's too fast, it's a little annoying. Ooh, that tearing might need to turn on V-Sync.
Doctor, the man who looked like me.
Doctor?
What did he want here?
There's a strange astronomical event happening right now. Something I can't begin to classify, but I think it's disabled our satellite. There's a very peculiar signal that we're receiving.
A signal? That's what I'm here for.
Well, so was he. But he didn't seem to understand it at all. He got very angry, sabotaged our imaging array, and now we're blind. I believe the event is still going on, but we can't pick it up.
Is there something we can do?
What he broke is essentially just a special camera, but we can't use the telescope without it. There's a replacement in my car. If you can get that to me, we're back in business.
Consider it done.
Why isn't the replacement inside of the building, lady? Call yourself a doctor. Can I take this? I'm like, bad guys! Be wary of my power! Oh, I can still talk to her. Tell me more about the signal.
Tell me more about the signal.
It's almost as if something's being transmitted to Night Springs. It's the strangest thing. It's quite elusive, almost as if it wasn't properly there. I don't know how to describe it.
So, what was the signal like?
I wish I knew. He appeared before I had a good fix on it. He was very pleasant when I was working, but when I isolated the signal, he suddenly forced me out of the control booth. He said it was none of my business. He seemed to change. Somehow, he was very smooth and charming before that, but suddenly he became... I'm sorry. I'm not sure I want to talk about it.
That... Your voice changed. Okay, do you always wear that to work?
I have to ask, do you always wear that to work?
I was at a party for a local art exhibition. Fascinating works. When I was called away by my assistant, Michael was the first to spot this event. I don't know where he is now, actually. He was supposed to bring us some food, but he never showed up.
Tell me about the event.
Oh, it's quite fascinating. It looks as if stars were changing, somehow. Or shifting positions. It isn't really happening, of course. Most likely it's caused by some kind of atmospheric refraction phenomenon. But I've never seen anything like it.
Oh, you're all doomed.
Did he hurt you?
No. He didn't quite threaten me exactly. But those shadowy things started to crawl into view. And whatever the signal was, he seemed to be extremely frustrated by it. He just started breaking things and left. I thought it best not to interfere.
Interesting. He's done much worse.
Yes. He showed me a knife, and he kept talking. He enjoyed the sound of his own voice. A proper maniac. You really aren't anything like him, are you?
Believe me, I try very hard not to be.
Turn your back to me after that? It's cool. Don't need you, I don't need nobody. Thanks. Maybe I need you a little. Onward and upward, my friends.
Good luck. And try to be careful. It's a very expensive part and we don't have a replacement.
Sure, sure.
Oh dear, that sounded more callous than I intended. Be safe.
You too. I feel like most likely, when I come back here, you'll be dead.